Shalom, brothers and sisters. Most High Christ bless. Welcome to another episode of 15 Minutes with the Captains. I'm Captain Naam, to my right.
Officer Benaya.
All praises. And today we're going to touch on a precept that the world, Christianity, right, has portrayed to mean everybody. All right. And it's Joel chapter 2 and 32. All right. We go get that. And you go get the right understanding today of the misconception of what you've been taught in your churches, all right? Let's read that.
Joel chapter 2 and verse 32. Uh-huh. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be delivered. Mm-hmm. For in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem shall be deliverance. Mm-hmm. As the Lord had said, in the remnant whom the Lord shall call.
So you see the scripture we just read, right? Christians will use this to say what? He's talking about everybody. Everybody in the whole world. Red, yellow, black, and white. That's who he's talking about. But the Most High God, in the context of this scripture or chapter that we're reading, he never separated from who he was talking to. All right? It's not all inclusive. The Bible is not all inclusive. That's what you've been taught in your Christian churches. All right? And that's a lie. Straight up lie. They're lying to you. All right? These gritty wolves are lying to you. We're trying to give you the right understanding and the truth and a true understanding of the scriptures, all right? Not continue to deceive you, all right? So from there, let's read verse, before we go there, read it again.
Joel chapter 2 and verse 32.
Uh-huh.
And it shall come to pass.
So it's, when it says it shall come to pass, meaning this is future tense. So this is a prophecy. This whole chapter is going to the prophecy of a destruction coming. You understand? To who? America. All right? But we're not going to read the whole chapter, but we're going to focus on this verse because that's what Christians do. They isolate scriptures. But we're going to jump throughout the chapter to further prove who the Most High is talking to. All right? So read it again.
And it shall come to pass, mm-hmm, that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord.
So that's where they will stop. That's where Christians will stop. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord. Let's see who had a, quote unquote, a personal relationship with God. Go to Deuteronomy 4 and verse 1. All right. Deuteronomy 4 and 1. Most High never dealt with all nations. He only dealt with the nation of Israel. That's it. But, you know, through Christianity, you've been deceived. You've been taught lies. All right. We're here to cast down those lies and falsehoods. Read that.
Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Now, therefore, hearken, O Israel.
Who?
O Israel.
Hearken, listen, O Israel. Israel. It's never changed. Go ahead.
Unto the statutes and unto the judgments which I teach you, for to do them.
For to do them. The law, statutes, and commandments was given to the nation of Israel. The Old Testament, meaning the Old Covenant and the New Covenant, is only for Israel. It never changed. Keep reading.
That ye may live.
That ye may live. Who? The children of Israel. Keep reading.
And go in and possess the land which the Lord God of your fathers, mm-hmm, giveth you.
Mm-hmm.
Ye shall not add unto the word which I command you.
So we can bring that up today, right? With Christianity, right? Christianity has taken away from God's word. You got scriptures that they literally taken out the Bible. Taken out the Bible with these NIVs, these New American Standards, these Bibles, that's not the King James. You understand? They're taking out certain words, all right? They're changing words like black. and taking it out, so you won't identify with who you are in this Bible. Go ahead.
Ye shall not add unto the word which I command you, mm-hmm. neither shall ye diminish aught from it, mm-hmm. that ye may keep the commandments of the Lord your God.
This is what we're supposed to have been doing from then to today. All right, from that captivity all the way up to this captivity we're in today. Go ahead.
Which I command you. Your eyes have seen what the Lord did because of Baal Peor. Mm-hmm. For all the men that follow Baal Peor, the Lord thy God have destroyed them from among you.
That's our people today. They following the devil. They following Christianity. But Christianity has continued to fill us and teach us lies, abominations to God's word. All right. Go ahead.
Verse 4. But ye that did cleave unto the Lord your God are alive, every one of you this day.
You got to slow down right there, because it said, but ye that did cleave unto your God, the Israelites' God, the God that created everybody upon the earth, but he's your God because he chose Israel. He didn't choose everybody else. You understand? You got to get that through your mind. Go ahead.
But ye that did cleave unto the Lord your God, uh-huh. are alive, every one of you, this day. Mm-hmm. Behold, I have taught you statutes and judgments.
You're alive because he spared our lives. Meaning, when you follow these commandments, you're alive. That's a state of living, not a state of death, all right? A dead state. Our people are in a dead state right now, up here in their mind, all right? The walking dead. Go ahead.
Even as the Lord my God commanded me, mm-hmm. that ye should do so in the land whither ye go to possess it.
Right. Go ahead.
Keep therefore and do them.
Do what? The commandments. Go ahead.
For this is your wisdom and your understanding in the sight of the nations.
We're supposed to be showing these nations how to operate, how to maneuver, how to deal with one another, love each other as we love ourselves. But we as a nation have departed from this, all right, separated from the Bible, right, because of what we've been taught as a nation. We're bringing it back to you, all right, go ahead.
Which shall hear all these statutes, mm-hmm. and say, surely this great nation is a wise and understanding people. Mm-hmm. For what nation is there so great? Who hath God so nigh unto them?
They say, who had God so nigh to them, meaning close to them? He's close to Israel. Because he's our God. Go back. Go back. Joel 2 and verse 27. In this same verse, we're going to bring out who God is talking to again in the same chapter. Read.
Joel chapter 2, verse 27.
Remember, read verse 1 first and then jump to 27.
Yes, sir. Joel chapter 2, verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Blow ye the trumpet in Zion.
In who?
In Zion.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
And sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Mm-hmm. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord cometh, for it is nigh at hand.
Right. The Most High is warning that Israel, that the destruction is coming. All right. Go ahead. 27.
Verse 27. Mm-hmm. And ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel.
God is in the midst, nigh unto us, the Israelites. Go ahead.
I am the Lord your God.
Our God. Go ahead.
None else.
And none else. Like, that's plainly written right there, right? If you can read, you can plainly understand and see that this says, and none else. So he's not the God of the so-called white man, Chinese, Arab, no other nation outside of the 12 tribes of Israel. Go ahead.
I am the Lord your God and none else. Uh-huh. And my people shall never be ashamed.
You should never be ashamed that you're a Shemite or a Semite, as they say, right? Because you are of that lineage. You are a Jew. You are from the 12 tribes of Israel, all right? Because you know what's going on today, all right? So from there, go back to 32 and read that.
Joel chapter 2, verse 32.
Uh-huh.
And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be delivered.
So that whosoever is talking about Israel, all right? Keep reading.
For
well,
in
before you go there, delivered from what? Go give me Ezekiel 3 and 11. Delivered from what? who's in a captive state right now? Who's in slavery right now? Who has oppressors over them today? Who has oppressors over them where you can't say what you need to say or want to say? You know what I'm saying? Right, handlers, right. This is the society, or this is the time that we're living in today, all right? We're being oppressed. Why? Because we're in captivity. All right, go ahead, read that.
Ezekiel chapter 3, verse 11.
Uh-huh.
And go, get thee to them of the captivity.
Of the captivity. We need to be delivered from the said captivity, all right? From Babylon to Assyrian, Persian and Mede, Greek, Roman, so on and so forth, to America. What do the so-called white man need to be delivered from? Somebody help me. Y'all help me out in understanding, what do the oppressor need to be delivered from? He's the one that is oppressing us as a nation of people. We're in the slums and ghettos. We have to go to him through the curses, which we're for to read in Deuteronomy chapter 28, for want of all things. This scripture that we're reading is talking about nobody but the children of Israel. Go ahead.
And go, get thee to them of the captivity, unto the children of thy people.
The children of thy people, the lost tribes of Israel. Go ahead.
And speak unto them and tell them, thus said the Lord God, whether they will hear or whether they will forbear.
Whether they will listen or they will forsake or not listen to a damn thing you say. Because that's most of our people today. They hear, but they don't want to hear. Why? Because it comes with responsibility. They don't want responsibility. They want to continue to live how the world or their oppressor has taught them to live, all right? Drop that. Go to Deuteronomy 28, 68. Deuteronomy 28, 68, because you have to establish who needs deliverance. Who needs the deliverance? We do. Why? Because we're in captivity right now. How do we come to this land? We're for to read it. Go ahead.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68.
Uh-huh.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
Egypt again with ships. Who did that happen to? Who went on cargo slave ships to another land that was not theirs? Who name was changed from Israel to black, to color, to African American? Yours was. Ours. We were sold to our enemies on auction slave blocks, all right? Master Charlie, Master Peterson, Master whoever. Whatever plantation, whoever bought you, you now were property of that plantation. That only happened to one nation of people, all right? Go ahead, finish it off.
And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
Your enemies, not your friends, but your enemies, all right? So showing you that you do have enemies, that God have nations that's against him and against you as being the 12 tribes. Go ahead.
For bondmen and bond women, mm-hmm. and no man shall buy you.
Meaning no man shall redeem or save you. But we're reading about, go back to Joel chapter 3, we're reading about being delivered. Meaning the other words are redeemed, saved, all right? Go ahead. Joel 3, and no, the last verse, 32.
Joel chapter 2, verse 32.
Uh-huh.
And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be delivered.
Delivered from what? Captivity, destruction. That's what this chapter is going over. Destruction coming. We're going to be delivered, the 12 tribes, from that. Go ahead.
For in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem shall be deliverance.
Shall be deliverance. Mount Zion. Give me Psalms. Jump up to verse. What I want. Verse 23 in Joel 2. And then we're going to go to Psalms.
Joel chapter 2, verse 23.
Just to identify who Zion is. Because, again, they isolate words and scriptures and try to make it for everybody. Go ahead.
Be glad then, ye children of Zion.
The children of Zion. That's us, the children of Israel. The subject never changed of who he's talking to or about. The children of Zion, the children of Israel. All right. Drop that. Go to Psalms 149 and 2. I think that's what I want. Psalms 149 and 2.
Psalms chapter 149, verse 2.
Uh-huh.
Let Israel rejoice in him that made him.
Let Israel rejoice in him that made him. Go ahead.
Let the children of Zion be joyful in their king.
Let the children of Zion, we just read that in Joel. The children of Zion be joyful in who? Their king. Christ is our king. joyful that what? Deliverance is coming to us, all right? We will be saved out of this captivity, all right? But that's what you applying the commandments to your life in the faith of Christ, all right? So drop that, go back, and read that latter part of Joel 2 and 32.
Joel chapter 2, verse 32, the bottom part. For in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem shall be deliverance, as the Lord had said.
As the Lord had said. Go ahead.
And in the remnant whom the Lord shall call.
Just the last part. And in the remnant whom God shall call. I got it right. Go to Romans. Romans 9 and 26. That remnant is us. Why? Via the curses. Deuteronomy 28 and 64, who was scattered abroad to the four corners of the earth. Deuteronomy 4 and 27. It's throughout the whole Bible depicting or categorizing the nation of people that will be scattered through the four corners of the earth and put in what? Bondage, slavery, captivity. That's us, the Israelites. All right, go ahead, read that.
Romans chapter 9, verse 26. And it shall come to pass.
Again, this is future prophecy. All right, go ahead.
That in the place where it was said unto them, ye are not my people.
Where was that said? Here in the Babylon. That's where you were told you're not a people. You're a color in a crayon box. All right? You 3/5 of a man. Here in America. Go ahead.
There shall they be called the children of the living God.
You see that? There. Here, America, we will come back to the understanding that we are the children of God. All right, go ahead.
Esaias also cried concerning Israel, though the number of the children of Israel be as the sand of the sea.
Be as the sand of the sea. And this is quoting Hosea 1 and 10. All right, go ahead.
A remnant
of who? The Israelites, the 12 tribes. That's who this whole Bible is about, written to, for, and about. All right? The redemption of the children of Israel. Read.
A remnant shall be saved.
A remnant. That's that deliverance. That remnant shall be saved from what? The destruction to come to these nations, to Babylon. All right? To the north. All right? That's it on that? All right. So now, just to precept it, go to Isaiah 10 and 20. All right? Just to show you that nothing changed from the old to the new. All right? This Bible has never changed. It's just your understanding has changed via captivity. All right, read that.
Isaiah chapter 10, verse 20. And it shall come to pass in that day that the remnant of Israel and such are as escape of the house of Jacob.
You got to stop right there and say the remnant of Israel. That's that remnant we read about in Joel chapter 3, verse 32. The remnant of Israel. All right. Did all inclusive? Did it say Moab? Did it say Ammon? Did it say Elam, Ishmael? No, Israel. Go ahead.
And it shall come to pass in that day that the remnant of Israel and such as are escaped of the house of Jacob.
Jacob, Israel, go ahead. 12 tribes.
Shall no more again stay upon him that smote them, but shall stay upon the Lord, the Holy One of Israel.
The Holy One of Israel. Our deliverance is through the Most High God. Through us keeping the commandments and the faith of Christ. So these are the steps that you need, brothers and sisters, to do what? Come back and turn back to the Most High God, is repent and keep the commandments and the faith of Christ. All right? I pray y'all got some understanding of Joel chapter 2, verse 32, to understand the whosoever is talking about is not talking about the whole world. It's talking about the children of Israel. All right? And with that, we say shalom.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone, 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.